We're back on Hockey TV, powered by the Illinois Media School. You're watching the Chicago Cougars. We have a 6-2 lead against the Detroit Fighting Irish. I'm Luke Steffen with Brandon Evans. Brandon, right towards the end of that third period, Detroit's goalie, Jeremy Couric, took a really unfortunate penalty, and it's put his team in an even bigger hole than their full four-goal deficit might suggest to start this period.
Yeah, double minor. Doesn't help your team at all. That's a ton of time being down a player with this big of a lead the Cougars have. You're digging yourself deeper into a hole. If the Cougars keep playing like they're playing, even if they don't score on this, their defense will pick up for them.
Chicago trying to get some enthusiasm. Their bench excited to start this period. Behind the net, it is the Cougars with the puck, sending it across to the far side. Now a long pass into the zone. Shot no good off the board. And cleared by Detroit. Behind the net, Martinovich with it. Settles things down for the Cougars. They'll look to reset on this power play. A little bit of pressure from Detroit. Mays providing it, as well as Cruz. Chicago breaks it, though. That shot is blocked. Big block there for Detroit. Trying to break out. They've actually got a 2-on-0 break. Mays' shot is stopped. Stopped by Martinovich at the 19-13 mark of the third period. Nice save. Let's take a look at the replay there. 19-12 to play in the third period.
2-on-0. Right there. Quick little tip.
That was a really critical save by Martinovich there to keep this margin at 4. Chicago with the puck now behind their net. Kavanaugh with it. Van Dyke now. The Cougars clear the zone. Dumped in. Behind the boards. Sent up. Kept in by Rifle for a minute and then knocked out by Detroit. In the neutral zone, Chicago gets the puck. We've got a stoppage in play. Penalty here. Penalty on Chicago. Penalty on the Cougars.
We have an interference call against Detroit. Against the Cougars.
Against
my bad.
It's Riffle going to the box for the Cougars.
We'll have a 5-second power play.
5-second power play for Chicago.
But 4-on-4, open ice, a lot of things could happen right now.
18:41 left in the game. Chicago a 6-2 lead right now. This faceoff comes from the far circle in the Cougar end. And it is eventually controlled by the Cougars. Back around. Center by the Fighting Irish. Anderson couldn't get the shot off, though, and now Chicago advances out. And we are at 4-on-4. Collision in the near corner. The puck is free. Skating around are the Cougars trying to get it. They keep it in. Looking for a shot here. Kavanaugh with it. Kavanaugh stick handling. That's a shot that just dribbles towards the net. No real threat there. It floats in front, though, and it has to be stopped. Stopped by Buchholz for Detroit. Buchholz back into the game after going out in the first period. Faceoff in the Detroit end. 17:58 in the third. 4-on-4 hockey right now.
With this third period just starting, quick little note. Michael Helf has 2 goals. Let's see if he can get the Hattie tonight.
It's a race between Cruz and Bishop for the puck, and Cruz actually snuck behind Bishop, got to the puck, but Bishop with a big hit on Cruz there. The puck is behind the Cougars' net. Now it's loose along the board. Shot wide by Blackburn. Kept in by Detroit but turned over. Here come the Cougars. Partial with it. Partial shot. Save. Rebound. Dribbled all right in front of the net. Just no one able to get their stick on it for Chicago. A chance there. Back come the Fighting Irish. Blackburn with it. Blackburn turns it over. And we've got health in. No, knocked away. The puck is loose. Can Chicago keep it in? Ross does Ross's shot. Save. Puck behind the net. Kept in again by Chicago. That shot blocked, but it goes to a Cougar player. That's 74. Mozalek with it. Chicago cycling that puck in front of the net. No. And the Cougars penalty is over. Brief power play has come to an end for the Cougars as Detroit's penalty now over. We're at even strength, 5-on-5, 16:30 to play in the third period. A 4-goal lead for the Chicago Cougars. The Cougars are able to get the puck up. Van Dyke with it. Now Van Dyke, a 2-on-1. His shot, no. Just over the shoulder of the Detroit goalie. Buchholz, the puck back into the Chicago end. Hayes floats it in. It was touched by a Cougar, so no icing. Detroit keeps it in. That shot bounces in front of the net. No real chance there. Out into the neutral zone. Who's going to get it? Tapped up into the Detroit bench there. It looks like it was Dijon that knocked it into his own bench for the Fighting Irish. So we'll have a faceoff in the neutral zone.
The Fighting Irish have had a lot of speed going into this third period, more than they've had in the first and second. This could be something for them right now.
Fired up a bit by the
deficit.
It's
hockey. Anything could happen.
Chicago, as we mentioned, they need to win this game. They need to win out and have some help from teams above them if they want to move up in the standings for the playoffs that are coming up. The Cougars looking good so far tonight with the puck behind the Detroit Nets. Sent out. Shot there. Wide. No. Sewell gets a stick on it but can't really control it for Detroit. Now Fernandez will advance out for the Fighting Irish to Mays. Mays back to Fernandez. Fernandez knocked away. Good defense there by the Cougars. Riffle gets it out. We've got a one-on-one here. And nice defense by the Fighting Irish. It's number 17 for them. Dombrowski with a big defensive play. Dombrowski with the puck now, skating it out himself. Nobody's stepping up for Chicago right now, allowing Dombrowski to take it himself. Skates in. Knocked away by the Cougars. Detroit keeps it in. And it goes to the far boards. Cruz working for it. Bishop back now behind his net for Chicago. And the Cougars get it. The Cougars try to clear the puck. They do. Here comes Marinovich for Chicago. Hayes knocks away from him for the Fighting Irish. Hayes skating with it. Turns it over to Delbrassine. But Detroit able to get back in possession of the puck. Now near center ice. And dumped into the Cougar end.
Big hit on Lindsay.
Kavanaugh to Ross. Puck not quite out. Shot blocked by the Cougars. Kavanaugh with that block. Across to Marinovich. Marinovich looking for a shot from the circle. Saved by Buchholz for Detroit. And then that shot knocked out by number 11, Tristan Cruz. Delbrassine with it in his own end. Gives it off to Lindsay. Lindsay momentarily skated it out, but turned it over. Now Lindsay with it near center ice. Nice effort by the Fighting Irish collectively to take that away. Mays skates in. Mays looking for a shot wide. That shot goes wide. Another shot blocked in front of the net by a defenseman. Dombrowski from the neutral zone. Gloved down by Martinovich. 13 minutes to play in the third period. A 4-goal lead still for the Cougars, but as we've said, Detroit, this is their best effort so far. Blackburn, no. Dombrowski eyes a shot, knocked down. He stays with it. This shot better. Rebound, no. Big save there. Detroit getting a lot of second chances, a lot of chances in general here in the third period. The puck along the near boards, collision there, the Cougars. Still aren't able to clear it. Dombrowski knocks it down, shoots it behind the Cougar net. race for the puck along the far boards. Kept in by Detroit. Lindsay, nice effort, prevented Detroit from getting anything going there. Eventually, the Cougars were able to clear. Detroit sends it back in. Now, Chicago really seems to be on their heels here in the third period. 12:15 to play. Chicago still, despite not having their best period, a four-goal lead. Helf skating it himself up. And he eventually had to give the puck up into this slot. Goal! Goal at the 12-minute mark. Chicago extends their lead to 5. 7-2 Cougars. Let's take a look at the replay on that.
Just beat the defense right there. Created some space. Got in front of the defenders. Was able to tuck in that rebound. That was a whole line goal by the Cougars. Everyone chipped in on that.
Could be a backbreaker for Detroit. They'd had so much energy and were playing hard.
And the momentum's starting to fall the Cougars' way.
Stoppage in play, the puck in the neutral zone there. Faceoff actually will be just outside the Detroit end. Detroit with it. Hayes skates it out for the Fighting Irish. Turned over, back to the Cougars. They'll look to regroup in their own end. Cruz putting some pressure on. And now, sent into the near corner of the Cougars. Chicago with a 5-goal lead. Van Dyke on his own, a breakaway for Van Dyke. Shot, he didn't really get his stick on it there. It let Buchholz make the save. If Van Dyke could have gotten his stick on it better, that might have been an 8th goal for the Cougars.
Yeah, it tried to make it look a little too pretty. That in tight, right there. He kind of tries stick handling, miscues it, loses it.
Faceoff from the near circle in Detroit's end. Weakly towards the Fighting Irish net. Delvercine with it now behind the net. Shot, score, goal. That's the 8th goal of the game at the 11-12 mark. That's the 8th goal for the Cougars.
Breakdown in the offensive of the neutral zone leads to a good rush by the Cougars in the defensive zone. Able to tuck in the quick little goal short side.
Mironovic with it there. He stays on the ice for the Cougars. Cougars making some defensive changes now, though. Mironovic with it again. Back into his own zone. Delbrassine with it. Delbrassine skates in. Knocked off the puck by a couple of Fighting Irish. Detroit gets it out. Given to Hartman for Chicago. Hartman a pass in his own end. Open space for Madonia. Shot no wide. Cougars get the rebound. Can they get to the puck here? No. No, Detroit able to get it out of danger there. Dumped back in by the Cougars. Buchholz settles it down behind his net. And now Detroit with space to get out of the zone. Turned over in the neutral zone there where they met resistance, and the Cougars send it back behind Detroit's net again. This time Peters back there for pressure, knocks it away. Peters with it now, centering pass, goes out to the blue line. And weakly centered there by the Cougars, nothing there. Still in Detroit's end, Ross unable to keep it in. Janik to Peters. Turned over. We've got a Cougar without a stick. The puck's still in Detroit's end. Along the near boards, in the near corner to be more precise. And now Detroit able to skate it out. Mays with it. 2-on-2 here. Good defense there by Kavanaugh to take it away from him. Here comes Kavanaugh by himself. And eventually he has to give it up. gives it up to Moore, but Moore turns it over to Lindsay. Nobody was up there to help except for Kavanaugh, who wasn't ready for that pass. Kavanaugh dumps it down to Marinovic. Behind the net in the far corner, now along the far boards. Battle there. Chicago sends it back there. Lindsay with it. Nobody's back there. Oh, we've got a penalty. And Kavanaugh not happy. Kavanaugh and Sewell for Detroit exchange pleasantries. Let's take a look at that. 9:06 to play in the third period.
Right there. Just tried skating it around. Tuck it in, but there was some action that the viewers didn't get to see, but
it was Kavanaugh and Sewell along the side. That's where the issue was.
Here's our pushing and shoving right there. Some jabs to the head.
Sewell, it looked like taking some liberty with Kavanaugh for the Cougars.
No.
Both players are in the backs.
Trying to get a little bit of fire in both teams right now.
Faceoff stays in the Detroit end momentarily, but now skating it out is Dombrowski for Detroit. Save by Martinovic. He stops play at 8:56 in the third. Chicago's added two goals to their lead here in the third period. It's now 8-2 Cougars. Delbrassine looking to make a move. Took the puck off the boards in the neutral zone, but good recovery by Detroit. You've got a penalty in the Detroit end.
That's going to be on. Who's that going to be on? Number 5 for the Fighting Irish, Hayes.
Christopher Hayes with the penalty for Detroit. So Chicago a chance to really, really blow this one open. Up 6 already.
Let's see if they try and help out Helf, try and get him that hat trick.
It doesn't look like he's out there to start. It's actually Lindsay taking this draw. He wins it for the Cougars. Ross, oh, there's a glove on the ice, it looks like.
And another penalty.
And another penalty. That was only 4 seconds after that.
Yeah. Tensions start to flare. Emotions come up big. When your team's down 6 goals, it's hard to just keep every emotion inside. You gotta let them out sometimes, even if that is taking a bad penalty.
It's actually Lindsay for the Cougars called for that penalty, so 4-on-4.
For 1:56. Let's see if the Cougars can keep this momentum up or if it's going to go in the favor of the Fighting Irish.
We, of course, skated back down to the Chicago end for this faceoff. Ross with a lot of space in front of him, and he just kicks the puck towards the blue line, not completely out, kept in. Now battle in front of the Cougar bench. Who comes up with it? Detroit does. Detroit, a shot, and it just rolls into the glove of Martinovic, who freezes it again. You're watching Hockey TV, the Chicago Cougars, presented by the Illinois Media School. I'm Luke Steffen. Brandon Evans has provided analysis for us tonight. Excited to say the Cougars a 6-goal lead right now in a game they must win. Behind the net after that faceoff. Dombrowski with it for Detroit. Centers it, Blackburn, shot, no. Good defense there by the Cougars. They got their stick on that shot. Now in front of the net, there's no Fighting Irish there for it. Blackburn keeps it in, dumps it in behind the net. And Blackburn a shot, big save there, knocked down Ross, but he was able to prevent it from even getting on net. Centering pass, nobody there for Detroit. Kept in by the Fighting Irish, Cruz behind the net. The Detroit player falls down, that's Brace that fell down for the Fighting Irish, still in the zone. Pass knocked away, and now Blackburn trying to prevent a breakaway for the Cougars. Open net. Goal. Goal. 9-2 Chicago. Big shot there.
Cash in on that 4-on-4. Had a little bit of trouble. Got it to the center for the open man. Not going to go wrong on that.
Pumped in with authority, it looked like there.
Yeah, the Cougars are taking charge of this game. From the get-go, they put the tempo in the game, showed who's going to win this game.
We were tied at 2. It's now a 7-0 run for the Cougars in terms of goals. Still 4-on-4 for another 30 seconds or so. Laukkanen skates in, and Paschal went down for a moment. He's able to collect himself and skate off, but a bit shaken up as he skates off. Peters with it for Chicago. Near dot, center save. And now along the far boards, Peters with it, battling for it now. A pile up, we've got 4 players over there. Detroit's at even strength, Chicago's at even strength in front of the net. Puck is...
score.
In.
Looked like the goalie stopped it, but...
it looked like it. I thought he had his glove on it. They say no. Let's see if we can see it.
The goal sat on the puck sat on the goal line for a second there. Seemed like right there, the goalie covered it and put it in his own net.
Oh, knocked it in himself. Bad break there. Tough break for Dean Buchholz. Pressed into action after the ejection of Jeremy Couric. Double digits now for the Cougars, 10-2. Chicago wins the faceoff, skating in, and they have it momentarily knocked away. Now we've got a stoppage in play. Faceoff will be in the neutral zone. 6:32 to play in the game. Knocked back, and Chicago controls the puck. Sent into the Detroit end. It slides all the way to the near boards. Chicago looking for another shot right in front of the net, saved by Buchholz this time. Still with the puck are the Cougars in the slot. No, knocked away by the Detroit defense. And now Irahanovich knocked down. Detroit clears it. Can anyone get to the puck for the Fighting Irish? No, the Cougars get to the puck first. They send it back in. Buchholz slows it there. Detroit tries to regroup. Kavanaugh will keep it back in Detroit's end. Just sort of shooting it back and forth there with no real purpose to it. All the way down to the blue line. Chicago controls it there. Ross turns it over. Not much of a shot there. Now in the far corner in the Chicago end. Detroit comes away with the puck momentarily. Nice work by the Cougar defense behind the boards to clear it out. And we've got a stoppage as they were crossing into the neutral zone. Penalty on Detroit. At the 5:16 mark of the third period, another penalty on the Fighting Irish. Down by 8, this is not what they want. It's number 26, Richard Hayward. He hasn't been on the ice much, but he's called for a penalty. Face-off in the Detroit end, controlled by the Cougars. Ross sends it across. Shot, no, rebound. Finally controlled by the Cougars, Delbrissine. Delbrissine long in front of the Detroit bench to Hawk. Hawk fires a shot, no, but the rebound came out. Detroit had it momentarily. It's back in Cougar possession along the far boards. Looking for a shot here. Ross with a shot, no. collision in the corner. Chicago's got the puck again. 4:40 to play in this game. A minute 20 on the penalty. Across, Ross couldn't quite get that in the corner. Chicago comes up with it again. Nice effort by Lenzi. Lenzi skating, sends it into the far circle. Muranovic with it. Muranovic behind the net. Muranovic still with the puck. Puck with it across. Not a lot of urgency at this point with an 8-goal lead. Shot blocked. Ross with it. Ross has it knocked away by Mays. Still in the near corner now behind the net to the center. Nothing there. Nobody could get their stick on it really solidly to get a good shot there. Back in the Chicago end. Martinovic slows things down. 30 seconds on a penalty. 3:45 for the period. The Cougars skate it up and turn it over. Looking for a long pass across ice to the near side of turnover. Barabas tried to sneak in and steal that unsuccessfully. Dombrowski with it now. Pressured. Anderson in a neutral zone towards the Cougar bench. Blackburn skating in. Blackburn shot. Big glove save there by Martinovic. Nice save by Martinovic. 3:19 in the game. Let's look at that save.
That was just a good save by Martinovic on a really nice wrist shot in the slot. Sometimes those wrist shots feel way more powerful than they are.
A baseball infielder couldn't have caught that one any nicer. That was really well seen by Martinovic.
He's got lightning in that glove tonight.
Yes. Thrown behind the Cougar net. They've got the puck now, skating out. Here comes Bishop. Bishop behind the Detroit net. Collision there. Who wants the puck? Chicago's got it. To the middle. Nothing there. Turned over. Back come the Fighting Irish. Yes. They might have a 3-on-1, 3-on-2 if they hurry. They don't really, though. Shot wide. Deflected a little bit there by Martinovic. Nice effort. Along the near board, Chicago comes up with the puck. 2:40 to play in the game. Long down there, and that's icing. Icing at the 2:36 mark. An 8-goal lead for the Cougars. They've reached double figures, 10-2 Chicago. Face off from the far circle. Spinning shot, no, wide. Center, nothing there. Good defense by the Cougars. There goes Delbrassine with the puck. Delbrassine, nobody in the middle for Chicago there. And out, cleared. Now it is in the hands of Hawk for Chicago. Knocked back down. The Cougar defense just trying to regroup. 2 minutes left. They don't have too much to worry about. It would take a miracle for something to make this game competitive at this point. Mays' backhand shot, nothing there. Knocked away by Martinovic and eventually knocked out by the Cougars. A minute 50 to play in the third period. Sewell with it. Sewell just fires a long shot. It was actually a pretty decent shot there by Sewell from the neutral zone. Martinovic freezes it. A minute 42 to play. And Ross talking to Martinovic now, telling him he's done a nice job, I'd assume. You have to like the effort that the Cougars goalie has shown today. Bounced back from a tough first 5 minutes, and it's allowed his team, which has been explosive at times this season, to get 10 goals in this game. Faceoff in the near circle in the Chicago end. Circling around, no one can get a stick on it. Wow, that was something you don't see often. Shot there, knocked down by the Cougar defense. Goes wide. And kept in by Dombrowski. Laukkanen fell down. Dombrowski, a big, strong shot that Martinovic just bodies up off of his body into the net. A minute 20 to play in the third period. face-off into Cougar End again. It's all cosmetic at this point. An 8-goal lead for the Cougars, 10-2. Behind the net and around to the far side boards. Detroit does momentarily keep it in. Now Chicago breaks out. Arahanovich looking for somebody. And turned over. Back comes Detroit, 2-on-2. Shot, body save with 1 minute remaining in the third period. Martinovich, a body save, just swallowed that shot up.
Hey, Luke. So I just want to let our listeners know, our viewers know, that Brandon has gone down to ice level. He's going to be trying to get Coach Stofers for an interview here after the game back up with you guys in the booth. So we're working on that for post game. So stay with us, folks.
Yes. Just 1 minute to play in this game. Chicago clears the puck into the Detroit end. We might have icing here, and we do at 52.8. Delays like this give Brandon time to run on down there and get to Coach Stofers. Everybody slowly skating back into the Cougar end. Peters will take the draw for Chicago against Blackburn. Blackburn getting a chance for Detroit. Blackburn goes down in the far circle. Chicago gets it out. And a little bit of a collision there. Into the middle. Detroit didn't really know where the puck was. It might give Chicago an opportunity. No, eventually knocked out in the neutral zone. Big collision. Oh, Peters is down and hurt. Does anyone see that? Peters is hurt with 22.6 seconds to play. Peters was violently knocked into the boards, checked into the boards, right in front of the penalty box. He is on his hands and knees right now, starting to slowly get up on one knee. His teammates around him. That was a big hit there. They'll talk to the referee about that. Let's see if we get a replay of that hit. So here we go. And Sewell is going to deliver that hit. Oh, boy, he didn't see him coming at all, and he just knocked him right into the boards. Sewell from behind. That was did not look like a sporting play to me there. Frustration from the Fighting Irish at this point. After 5 minutes of even play for the rest of this game, the Cougars have taken it to them on the scoreboard. Detroit trying to take it back physically. That doesn't really matter all of that much. It's about winning and losing. Less than 20 seconds to play in the period. Puck in the Chicago end along the far side. 10 seconds left. Chicago's going to clear it here. Skating it up is Hartman. And that's going to do it. A nice win, a needed win for the Cougars. They bounce back after a really frustrating weekend last weekend. A 10-2 victory for the Cougars over the Detroit Fighting Irish. Let's take a quick break now. When we come back on Hockey TV, Brandon and I will do a recap of this game. Hopefully we will have a special guest.
Well, I got started back in 2010. I was freelance sports writing for a couple different newspapers with the Sun-Times, and I wasn't really finding a permanent job, which is what I really wanted. And I would always hear those commercials on the radio about ICB, and I finally went in, and everyone was pretty welcoming. While I was there, all the instructors were very helpful, and it's just a great place to take advantage of their internships. I mean, you can get pretty much any internship you want if you put your mind to it. I know while I was there, I interned both at Comcast Sportsnet Chicago and at The Score, both at the same time. So they give you the options, but you need to work for it yourself. You can't just sit back and expect everything to come to you and everything to be served to you on a platter, because that's not how the world works and that's not how anywhere works. And although I still have a full-time job here at 23, I still like to get out and do broadcasts with IMS, even this past summer and spring, spending time doing games for Aurora Borealis, because it's still good. Even though I'm doing this job in the studio, I'm stuck in the studio, I don't really still get to get those opportunities to go out and call soccer games, call whatever games, and still, even just, you know, helping out current students that are there, they like to hear the advice from me, so I always like to still get out and do stuff like that. My name is Mike Buda. I'm the weekend sports anchor at Channel 23 News in Rockford, and I am IMS.
We're here with Coach Brad Stouffer of a great win from the Chicago Cougars tonight. What was your game plan going into tonight's game after losing three straight to the Wisconsin Rapid River Kings?
Yeah, there's not a lot of time left in the season, so we need to start getting on a roll. The plan, you know, for tonight was to have a strong start to the weekend. It's a weekend where we need as many points as we can get heading down the stretch. The standings are pretty tight, and we're trying to lock up a home ice playoff series here in the first round, and it's not going to be easy. You know, it never is this time of year, so the plan was just to come out, play a hard style of game, play our way, kind of get back, try to get back on a roll, playing our style of hockey, which is fast, skilled, and hard to play against. I thought for the most part we did that tonight.
It got a little bit physical towards the end of that game as it went on with a couple more games against Detroit. Is that something that you get a little bit concerned about? A couple guys looked really shaken up, especially that last hit at the end there.
Yeah, there are a few hits that were, you know, questionable. I mean, this team, Detroit is the most penalized team in the league, you know, out of 27 teams. So it was one of our focuses coming in, just to stay disciplined, you know, and looking at the next two games here this weekend to close out the weekend, it's something, you know, we have to continue to stay disciplined and, you know, watch our heads. I mean, watch your back, you know. I don't think they're necessarily dirty tonight. You know, there were a couple hits that were questionable, dirty, but they just play a hard game and finish their checks and hard style of play. So I think if we continue to stay out of the box and don't retaliate, I think we'll be okay as long as we come out of the weekend healthy.
One of the things that I noticed from the past three games is traffic in front of the net wasn't as much as you guys seemed like you wanted. Tonight you had bodies in front of the net picking up those greasy goals. What was the kind of like word that you said to the boys to get them going and get in front of the net?
Well, just getting back to our game plan, our style of hockey. You know, I thought it was much better tonight, probably four or five rebound goals and another one or two right around that area. So you have to pay the price to score goals. Doesn't matter what level of hockey you're at, you have to get to those tough areas, the net front areas, in between, you know, the hash marks, down in that gritty area, and that's where guys make their money in the NHL. It's where the majority of goals are scored, right in that area. And, you know, it takes will to get there. You know, it takes heart. It takes commitment. You have to want to be doing it. It's not a fancy place to be, but that's where a lot of the goals are scored. And I thought tonight we just had a higher will to get to that area that we've had in a couple games past.
Coach, thank you. Good win.
Thanks, guys,
tonight.
Appreciate it.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much, guys.